Welcome back to my channel. Ayan. So today, I'll be giving you updates coming from the Department of Education and some concerns and issues related to Department of Education. At isa sa mga i-share ko ngayon sa inyo is itong about mathematical investigation. So I hope may matutunan kayo dito and how to make a mathematical investigation in simplest form. So ibibigay ko sa inyo kung ano yung ating simplest part of the mathematical investigation. So it is entitled Hashtag PolyMeetsDots or in PolyDots. So with me, I am Arbert Lanchita and my co-partners, we have Mark Daniel Peler and Sir Eleuterio A. Canoy Jr. Okay? At dahil dyan, before we are going to start, kung hindi ka pa nakapag-subscribe sa aking channel, just hit the subscribe button na nasa ilalim for more update about our video. So if you are going to visit my YouTube channel, ang dami ko din doon sa mga action research. Kung gusto niyo ng soft copy, you can drop your email address doon sa comment section ng video para ma-send ko sa inyo. At sa mga nagre-request naman, antay-antay lamang po kasi napakadami po ang nagre-request. At saka yung bibigyan ko lamang po ay yung nag-subscribe sa aking channel. Ayan, so we will start. Ayan, sa ating mathematical investigation. The first part is the rationale. Okay? So, kung gusto mo naman ng soft copy nito, drop your email address sa comment section. So, a polynomial isn't as complicated as it sounds because it's just an algebraic expression with several terms. Usually, polynomials have more than one term, and each term can be a variable, a number, or some combination of variables and numbers. And, of course, according to or based on DGL 2018, he emphasized that in algebra, many algebraic expressions are polynomials and not all of them. While a polynomial can include constants such as 3, negative 4, and or 1/2, variables which are often denoted by letters and exponents. So there are two things polynomials can't include. The first is division by a variable. So an expression that contains a term like 7 over y is not a polynomial. So the second forbidden element is a negative exponent because it amounts to division by a variable. So titignan natin dito kasi mamaya ito yung ating gagawa ng study. So, based dito, there are a lot of ways in dividing polynomials. Some of the common methods we use. So, we have the synthetic division, the long division. So, we have a lot of things or ways to divide polynomials. But through this investigation, we could actually use it and formulate another way to solve polynomials with and without remainders. At titignan natin dito kung ano ba yung na-come up namin na other ways to solve polynomials. Ayan. So, situation, one of the easiest methods to find the quotient when dividing polynomials both with and without remainder was the use of that method. So, itong i-introduce ko sa inyo yung ginatawag namin na that method. In dividing polynomials, each numerical coefficient in the dividend was represented by a dot, and each term of the dividend was separated by a vertical line. So, on the other hand, the numerical coefficient in the divisor served as the guide on how many dots being connected. Ayan. So, mamaya malalaman ninyo kung paano namin ito ginawa. So, for our statement of the problem, this mathematical investigation would like to establish a pattern that could be used to find the quotient when dividing polynomials with and without remainders. So, specifically, this mathematical investigation, of course, sought to answer the following questions. Number one, what is the quotient when dividing polynomials with no remainder using that method? Number two natin is, yung what is the quotient when dividing polynomials with remainder using that method. Ayan. So, in gathering a data and models formulated, so if you could actually see the diagram, so babasahin ko na lamang po because it actually explain kung ano yung nakita natin sa table. So, like for instance, we have 1,131 divided by 11. So, by using that method, we have the illustration. So, actually, you can divide it using the synthetic division or the long division, but this dot method is another way kasi napakadali lang siya. So, tignan natin dito ang explanation. From above, we need to arrange the dividends from 1,000 to 1 separated by columns. The number of the divisor must be the number of the connecting dots, since 11 as our divisor contains 1 dot for 1s and 1 dot for 10s, therefore only 1 dot must be connected to another column. Ayan. So to further explain, we have this one. Then count the number of the original dot which you have connected to other dot found in the other column. So column 1 has 1 connected circle, second column has 2 connected circles, and 3 has 1. Therefore, the answer is 1, 2, 1, or 121. O, diba? Napakadali lang using our dot method. You could actually get the quotient of our equation. Ayan. So, how about solving mathematical problems using the model? So, number 1, or proving conjecture number 1. So, we will involve na dividing polynomials with no remainder. So, titignan natin dito. When finding the quotient of x5th plus 3x4 plus 3x3 plus 3x squared plus 4x plus 2 divided by x squared plus 2x plus 1, first, the polynomial equation must be in standard form. So, meaning, the exponent must be arranged in ascending order. So, titignan natin. Kailangan kasi yung power niya is naka-arrange siya. Ayan. So, from highest to lowest para makuha natin yung numerical coefficient. So, tingnan natin dito ha. The values of the numerical coefficient and the divisor were used as the pattern in connecting dots or dot in the dividend, meaning the first column in the divisor has 1 dot, which was connected to the second column having 2 dots, and the third column with 1 dot. O, diba? So, napakadali lamang siya. Okay, so on the other hand, arrange the numerical coefficient in each column. From the dividend, draw a dot or dots that would correspond to the value of numerical coefficients. Connect the dots from one column to another column. Just follow the patterns in connecting dots in the divisor. Ayan. Then count the number of the original dot which you have connected to other dots found in other columns. So column 1 has 1 connected circle, second column has 1 connected circle, and the column 3 has 0. And then column 4 has 2 connected circles, and column 5 and 6 has none. So to find the exact exponent of the first letter of coefficient, just subtract the highest exponents of the dividend and the divisor. Di ba napakadali lang? Therefore, our answer is x cubed plus x squared plus 2. O, di ba napakadali lang siya using our dot method solving a polynomial. So about proving conjecture number 2 natin, dividing polynomials with remainder. Ayan, or okay na, without remainder, ito naman siya is with remainder na siya. So, with when 2x5 plus x6 plus 3x4 plus 2xq plus x plus 2x squared plus x plus 2 is divided by x plus 1. So, the same pattern is we're going to use. Make sure that the polynomial equation was standard form. So, meaning to say, it's in a standard in ascending order, especially the tower. So, titignan natin dito yung explanation. Column 1 and 2 has 1 connected circle, column 2 has 2 connected circles, column 4 has none, column 5 has 1 connected circle, and column 6 has none respectively. So moreover, in column have remaining 2 dots that were not connected, meaning it served as the remainder of the quotient. So therefore, our answer is x5 plus x4 plus 2x3 plus x plus 2 all over x plus 1. So x 2 all over x plus 1 would be our remainder. Yan, yung ating 2 natin. So, yan yung tamang paglagay ng remainder sa ating polynomial. For our extension, based on the results and findings of the above said modeling using the dot method in dividing which with and without remainder, the following recommendations were suggested. There must be a parallel study where the signs of the dividend and divisor are both negative and unlike signs. Yan yung mga recommendations natin. It is also highly recommended to consider the coefficients of the dividend and the divisor that are fractions. Number 3, using the same method, other researchers may continue or pursue a parallel study considering the numerical coefficient of the dividend or more than one digit. And number 4 natin, this method is not applicable only for or is not yet applicable for mathematical polynomial equations, especially if the quotient is negative or fraction form coefficient. Ayan. And then the last part is the coefficient. So, yun lamang po yung basic part ng ating mathematical modeling natin. So, I hope you learned something. So, next video natin, I will be explaining also and some of the basic sample of mathematical investigation. So, ayan. So, maraming salamat po for watching. God bless everyone, and I hope you learn something for this day.